What's up, guys? Welcome back to the MSR Workshop. So in today's video, we are going to be going and doing another little project video on this Acmer 6-watt diode laser that was sent to me for testing and review. I think this will be a fun video, so stick around. Let's get into this. Okay, guys, so the project that we are going to try first is we are going to try and make a rubber stamp. And I have done this on my large CO2 laser and it works great. So we're going to see if we can do this on a diode laser. Now, one thing, I did a couple just test cuts to see if I could actually cut through rubber with a diode laser. It does not cut very well, at least with a 6-watt laser. So ideally, you just want to use it to remove the top material for the rubber stamp itself, and then maybe just use the diode laser to do an outline and just cut the remainder out with a pair of scissors and then glue it on your block of wood. So what we'll go ahead and do is jump into LightBurn and I'll show you how to set this project up and then we'll get to cutting. So now that we're in LightBurn, we are going to go ahead and select our cutting surface for this little Acmer 6-watt diode laser. And once you've got this started up and your machine powered on, we are going to select a file. And so most of the time you can actually drag and drop an image to your LightBurn desktop. And let me select everything here just to shrink this down. And we can use this little cross up here to kind of move our cutting mat around. Go back to the arrow here, and then we'll just shrink this. And I actually need to flip this over. So if you want to flip something over, you can come up to these little guys up here and just hit that, and it's going to flip it over. So one thing you need to remember is when you're doing a rubber stamp, you actually need to do it in the reverse. So right now, if you're looking at this, it's backwards, and that's what you want, because when it actually stamps out, it's going to stamp out in the correct direction. So we're going to actually engrave the Acmer logo and name onto a piece of stamp rubber that I got off of Amazon. And I'll make sure to leave a link below where I got all my materials. So I'm going to select my image and we'll go back up to our little circle guy and we'll go outward, but we're going to go a whole bunch this time. Let me move this out of the way so you can see what I'm doing. So if I hit this line, right now it's set to outward. So now, if we hit OK with that, now this is where it's going to make a line, or actually fill. Instead of having all this material over here that it's going to have to remove, it's just removing the inside stuff. And that's good. I'm going to select it one more time. And we're going to go back to that 0.9, hit OK, change that to blue, and now that's actually a cut line. So it's going to fill just this inline area here, and then go back over around the edge, and this is where we would cut out with our scissors. And you can actually just, you know, cut however you want, but at least this gives it a defined area where it will cut. So now let's figure out our settings. So my fill settings, I went ahead and tried just a tiny little square before, and I found that a speed of 30 millimeters per second and 100% power worked quite well. And I'm going to do 175 lines per inch. Now, if you bump this lines per inch up more, it actually slows your whole process down because it's going more passes. So right now that's a pretty good resolution. Now the bigger your picture you get, the higher resolution you want, because it's really going to stretch that picture and that graphic out a little bit. So we'll keep it at about 175. We're going to do a bi-directional fill, which means it goes back and forth, and then a crosshatch, it goes up and down as well. So 30% power, or excuse me, 30 millimeters a second, 100% power, bidirectional fill, crosshatch, and 175 lines per second. Our cut line, we don't really need it to do much, just because we just want it to make one little pass so we can go back and cut it out with our scissors. So let's go ahead and do 10 millimeters per second at, we'll say, 50% power. That'll just make a little bitty line that we can see once it is done. Next, we are going to frame this out on our work material and kind of figure out how big we want this. So let's get back down to the laser so you guys can see what we're doing. Okay, so this is our rubber. This is about 2 mil thick rubber, maybe 2.5. I'm gonna go ahead and set my machine on top of it. And then we are gonna make sure that we have our height of our laser set right, and we're gonna use this little piece of plastic to put in between our material and this guy here, and this tells us our correct height. This is our set screw, so we can raise this up and down. Once we get that set, then we'll remove that, and now we know we have our correct focal distance. And so double checking our preview, this is going to say it's going to take 20 minutes because this is not a very fast little laser. And on my fill settings, I'm actually gonna go ahead and do 3 passes just to make sure that we take enough material off the top so we have this nice and raised out. So let's get to cutting. Guys, so it's all done. Let's take a look and see how it is. So that looks pretty good. Now let's go over and cut this out and get this mounted. So we'll go ahead and get this cut out. And really, I don't want to just cut out any of the recessed part, because if you leave the raised part on the edges, then whenever you ink this, it's going to hit and leave a mark there as well. Okay, more or less. Now let's go ahead and clean it off. And we're gonna go ahead and use some acetone and just like a microfiber cloth just to clean up all the leftover gummy residue that our laser may have left on this. And one thing about diode lasers, it really does help if you have an air assist. Now I know this little 6-watt guy does not, but the larger one that has a built-in air assist does kind of help clean this off a little bit better. Also, it makes it so you can cut a little bit deeper. Now, this actually did really well with 3 passes. I actually stopped it a little early because 3 passes with the resolution that I had actually was going to be a little bit deeper than I actually needed. So let's go ahead and mount this, and we'll be right back. So I just grabbed a little scrap block of wood. Use CA glue or whatever. CA glue actually worked pretty good. Give that a second to dry,
And then we'll grab an ink and we'll try it out. Now, if you actually want to put the picture on the reverse side, you can just engrave the logo on the opposite side so you have your picture on your opposite side of your rubber stamp too. Okay, so I'm going to grab a gel ink pigment pad. You don't have to use this type. This is actually for embossing, so it tends to leave a little bit more ink behind, and you may not want as wet of an ink. So just a regular permanent ink would work too. So and that left a perfect little rubber stamp. Let's do that one again. So this would be a great way if you want a logo on any products that you ship. Make your own rubber stamp. Pretty simple. Okay guys, and now next we are going to try one of these little aluminum business cards that Acmer sent with the laser. And we're going to just go ahead and stick with the same thing. We're going to use the Acmer logo, except this time we're going to flip the logo over and try the same thing. So I'm just going to lay that in the middle there. And once again, you'll have to set your height of your laser. So, our little sheet block under there. Flatten that down, and we're good to go. Okay, so let's get this framed out. And I think I got this pretty straight. Let's try this one more time. Good. I'm going to bump the power down to 60% just to try and make sure that I don't get this little card too hot. And if we find out that it's too light, we will come back and go over it again. So let's go ahead and hit preview, and this should take 3 minutes approximately. And start. Guys, so let's take a look and see what we did. So one thing I did is I had to stop it off camera and restart it because I did not secure my card down and it moved just a little bit. So I just used a little bitty magnet. But let's take a look and see how it did. So it looks pretty good, and there might be just a little bit of soot that I could clean off of this, but those settings were pretty darn good. You could bump up your lines per inch a little bit. Sorry, I'm getting so much reflection, my camera doesn't want to focus. There we go. But that worked quite well. And you can make business cards. You could logo laser a QR code on the back. You could put even an NFC reader or a tap touch thing on it. You could make some pretty cool stuff with little metal business cards.
All right, guys, that is it for this video. I was really happy with these two little projects and the way they turned out. Now, I do wish the laser had a little bit more power just so I could cut out my rubber stamp instead of having to cut it out with a pair of scissors, but it's not the end of the world. And this little stamp turned out really well. Next, we lasered our Acmer logo onto this little metal business card that was included in our kit, which also turned out quite well. But if you want to know more about the Acmer 6-watt diode laser that was sent to me for review, check out my description below in the link, and there will also be a little discount code to help you guys out if you want to purchase one of your own. Now, if there is any comments, questions, or suggestions, I try to respond to everybody, but I would love for you guys to hit that like and subscribe button and stay tuned for all the videos that I drop. Until next time, guys, thanks again.